start the interview with DC.
So this place, it seems like it's started to create itself.
Yes.
Over the years.
This was clear, yeah, from the very beginning. Because all of a sudden, when we needed an architect, we needed someone to build the roof, and the right persons appeared. And it has been going pretty much like this. In the beginning, it was supposed to be a place for the Gurdjieff movements, because I've been working with this discipline for many, many years, and we wanted a place just like this. And then life showed us in all these years that it was not really our own creation. We must have picked up on some astral design, put it together, and now it's being used in different ways from the original plan. Mm-hmm. Which is not abandoned, it's just becoming bigger, much bigger than we thought. Mm-hmm.
For me, it's when I saw the people feeling the beauty here and feeling the inspiration of the place, the beauty of nature. Yeah. Because then I feel really that what we did, this was what we had to do. Yeah. We wanted to share this beauty, but we cannot keep it for ourselves. We drink a Coca-Cola in the swimming pool, and that's all.
Yeah, for me also, the joy is when I see that things are growing of their own accord. So a new person comes and brings such an idea, and then this idea brings such a new development.
Something else also which brings me a lot of joy, and to see the local community growing here. And when we came, there are a few persons who are living there already, but not so much. And more people are coming, and there is a Buddha field growing here, which is, it was not at all expected. Mm-hmm. But no, it's very beautiful. A lot of friends, a lot of things happening more and more, new centers, new activities, new... Yeah.
Yes, we are also part of some gathering that started before we came and which has increased since we are here. So more and more seekers who want meditation and beauty and also look for some holiday, they start to look to this place more and more.
Feel this peace.
Yes, I don't forget my master Osho. One of the most recurrently successful activities here is that we have on Saturday night in Osho Discos. And the whole community gathers, and it's such a beautiful, light and silent, profound time of the day, which happens every week since before the Buddha Hall started. We had started in our house or in people's house. To open to the potential that still is in this planet Earth, Mother Earth, to open to the potential inside of each of us, to keep this opening and to trust the heart to take you where you need to go next, and to have the courage to take whatever step comes, and the trust that you are being seen, supported, loved.
And really my message from my experience is to follow life, to follow what is happening, to accept, to surrender to life. And be happy what is here and now. And things are coming. They come from abundance, from life, from the universe.
And also if you feel that you're stuck in a rut, try something new. Come to Corfu for some time.
For me, the vertical way to life is really to see that we are loved. Love exist. It's not something that you have to search for. It's you are in all the time. And for me, the vertical way to see life is to see the beauty everywhere, all the time. To be grateful also, to be grateful to the nature, to the trees, to the wind. Sempre olho para o firmamento, e eu vejo grande poder. E eu sou pequeno aqui na terra, peço força para compreender. E eu sou pequeno aqui na terra, peço força para compreender. Sempre olho para a humanidade, a multidão me desperta. Sempre olho. Em ver tanta criatura e todos ter que seguir na rota certa. Em ver tanta criatura e todos ter que seguir na rota certa. Eu vejo.